Hey, welcome back to New Gameplay Today. I'm Leo Vader. Joining me today is Ben Reeves.
Hello.
And Dan Tack.
What's up, everybody? Welcome.
Will someone please tell me what we're looking at?
This isn't a new game. I mean, it is going to be a new game. It's Wasteland 3, everybody. Comes out this fall, and it's on our cover this month, so we decided to show it off to you guys.
Yeah.
Dan, you have a history of this franchise, right?
It's on our cover, you say?
On the Game Informer cover.
I do have a history. You know what? I never played the first one. Well, I mean, I did play the first one, but I don't remember playing the first one, if you know what I mean. It was one of those very early seminal PC games.
Yeah.
And I, of course, I did play through the second one. Did a review on that one. So let's break it down, Reeves. What are the big changes people are going to see from Wasteland 2 to Wasteland 3?
Oh, just jump right into it.
Well, hey, that's what I like to do. We can take it easy. We can go slow if you like.
Yeah, I mean, as you can see, we're in combat right now, and one of the big changes to combat is the Wasteland 2 had a turn order in that you had initiative, and so your guys' turns would be kind of mixed in with enemy turns. But we've changed that to a more traditional XCOM style, like the old XCOMs, not the new XCOM.
Yeah, they traded their style with XCOM.
It's all very confusing now. So it's now like all of your characters are kind of lumped into one turn, and you can issue commands and coordinate strategies. So they think it offers a bit more of a tactical feel. And I agree. I think I like the combat in this better. So that's kind of one of the big changes.
All right.
Go off and look about right now. But yeah, I went back. I wrote the cover. Surprise, surprise. So I did go back and play the first Wasteland, which was Trip, because I had never played it back in the day either. But I actually had a good time with it. I was actually kind of surprised about how much I was enjoying it. You know, it's a game from like 1988, so it definitely looks old, but some of the tools underneath and the world they created, it's still kind of fun to explore, just knowing, hey, this game is over 30 years old, but it still holds up in some respects. It was one of the first post-apocalyptic RPGs, and it helped inspire the creation of the Fallout franchise, if you're not familiar with that.
Yeah, you can definitely
I've
see
heard
that.
Of that one.
You've heard of that one?
Yeah, I've heard of that. I was like, you know, I was at my store and I saw a box copy sitting on the shelf. I was like, whoa, what's this?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was, so Interplay, Brian Fargo, one of the original creators, founder of Interplay. They created Wasteland in the 80s, and then 10 years later, they're like, we want to make another Fallout, and EA didn't want to do it. They were the publisher.
No.
They're like, nah, it doesn't seem worth it to us. Thanks anyway. So eventually Interplay is just like, fine, we'll do it ourselves. And they created Fallout as the spiritual successor. And I think in a lot of ways, Fallout's become the more well-known brand. But this is kind of where it started. And if you were a fan of like the first couple Fallouts, the first two Fallouts, in a lot of ways, this is kind of a truer sequel in some ways than the Bethesda entries.
You know, they started it and they're going to finish it. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
I see people moving around. I see people shooting. There's cover.
Yeah.
Very XCOM-y. I mean, obviously the other games still had this kind of tactical play, but this looks more a little bit more polished and refined for systems that players might immediately understand.
Yeah, for sure.
Though obviously still very early.
Oh,
they gave
definitely.
Us a very early build of the game, which we're very grateful for.
Oh, yeah. You'll notice a few hiccups here and there.
Maybe you might notice a bug somewhere.
You might notice a few characters really like jogging. I don't think that's a bug.
They all have their specific traits.
Tell me about the dog there. Is that a bug or is that a dog?
That's a real live dog who's my friend.
Okay, I'm really into that.
William, the two characters I started with, William and Lee Sing, they're a father daughter. They're one of the prefabbed duos you can start out with. And the father never speaks as a solemn warrior, and Lee Sing as a sniper. And the father can tame animals and charm them, and they'll help him fight. This dog has been doing rabid bites and poisoning enemies, which has been really useful. I just found him in the town we were just in and charmed him, and now he's following us around.
Oh, that's awesome.
So I don't know who we belong to.
The whole like pick two at the beginning of the game, and you can like pick from the prefabs or make your own is a very cool concept. You can really get granular with your hero creation in this. I noticed that like you can pick all kinds of crazy stuff. You can make your guy like a drug addict, for instance, or something like, you know, that he's going to be really powerful, but he's going to need to make sure he keeps getting his fix.
Yeah.
Yeah. Interesting quirks with trade-offs. And I'll point out that that's only your first four slots here. I've got the two I started with, then one I picked from a set of prefabs and one I made from scratch, Two-Face, who does like brass knuckles punch combos. And then the last two are companions that are you'll get over the course of the story and can lose, they can lose faith in you or die or whatever. Mm-hmm.
Right.
But they have a bit more writing and dialogue.
You can really, like, you can make very unique builds, though. It's not just like, hey, I'm good with shotguns, or hey, I'm good with, you know, bomb, or I can pick locks. There's some really, like, really wacky stuff that you can pick to, like, make very interesting and probably very difficult to play builds.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you get up to six characters pretty quickly, which is nice.
Oh, yeah, no time at all. We're barely over an hour in on this playthrough.
Yeah, you can fill out your squad with, you know, random characters, or you can, you know, collect a bunch of characters in the world who talk, like the character you're using there is an NPC, well, actually a player character at this point, but yeah, she's a character in the world who has motivations and history, and she'll give you story quests and that kind of thing.
Yeah, we're on a mission to save her family right now. That's actually what we're getting up to here. Something I like about the combat system is, obviously, everybody has their different set of movement, but you can see this kind of blue outline is where you can go and still attack, and once you get into the orange outline, that's where if you get there, you maybe have AP for one of your abilities or to defend or something, but you won't be able to shoot once you get there. And it's very clear where you're going, what percentage of a hit you're going to have, what percentage chance.
Yeah, that is also
I like that a lot. That's a big improvement from 2. Where you didn't get that kind of data immediately, like when you were making them, you had to like kind of just guess at some points.
Yeah, and something else I like, which I'll say I don't have much history with this franchise, so I'm not sure what's new, but I'm sure there are other people who are new to it as well. I appreciate that for the end of action turns, you've got defend and you've got prepare, where you can take AP over to the next one, and you've got ambush, which is kind of the Overwatch. And ambush and defend are both benefited the more points you have left over. So if you have a bunch of points left over, you can still make them useful and not feel like you're wasting a turn because you weren't able to get all your points out. I think that's designed in a cool way.
Yeah, the nice thing too about that AP system is, you know, something like XCOM, you have like a move and an attack, where this, it's like you have so many AP, you can like spend all your AP and dish out like multiple attacks. You can spend some AP on attack, some AP on a move. Like, there you have a little bit more flexibility, I think, in terms of how your characters dish out damage.
Yeah, if you like prepare and bring extra AP to a turn, you can run up, hit them, and then back off all in one turn. Which you feel smart when you can pull that off.
Ooh. I like being smart every day.
Oh, big miss. Big miss.
It was a big miss.
I'm gonna finish them with close quarters.
So tell me, what the hell, what is going on here at this point in the game? What's this? Walk me through. What's happening here?
What's going on?
Yeah, to be clear, this is like Leo's playing the game. This is his build that he started.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I need
Let's
to
listen to what this
you.
Guy has to say real quick, and Bellamy, then we'll recap story.
Bellamy, look at me. Have you seen my family? Are they here?
Lucia?
You have to click to advance, which I always forget.
Oh, thank God you're not. Thank God. They went up ahead with their hostages, but... Lucia, I heard gunfire and screaming. You need to be ready for the worst.
If they've done anything to my people, I'm going to end them all.
Please do. I'll tell whatever I can to help. It's not much, but... I think they took everyone to their camp. Just past the Gateway Rocks.
What about my family, Belle?
Last I saw them, they were all right. They were scared and a little banged up, but they were still alive.
Characters
I'm
will...
sure nothing happened to them.
No. Characters will have skills that apply to dialogue.
It. Yeah.
You can have kick-ass or smart-ass replies.
And if you've never played a Wasteland game before, like, all of your character's skills like go into a pool, so if you're in a dialogue with somebody you know, all of your character options will pop up. So if somebody's really good at like hard ass, for example, that'll be a dialogue option. But then you might also have a dialogue option for, you know, negotiation or something that another character has.
Right. So
it's kind of like all of your characters are pooled together as like one entity, which is nice.
I really love that you can see super clearly the other party members that have that ability. So you know what you're doubling up on and what you don't need to invest in because you've got somebody else who's already doing it.
Yeah.
I think that's
That is nice.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah. Party members over there. So there's a fragmine there you might want to be careful of.
Yeah. I think Lee Sing is my best with disarm explosives.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
Yeah. The other thing is you can just click on it and it'll pick the person that has the option there.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Let's talk about what just happened. Cause I thought Lee Sing was my repair person or my disarm explosive person, but clearly she's going to fail if she takes over that explosive. But when I press space to select everybody, it'll say it'll be a success. Cause it'll select the right person to do it.
Yeah.
Which I was too foolish to do.
That's pretty clever.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is really nice.
Although the first time I played this, I did just run the whole group through this place and not notice these bombs until it was too late. My poor guys
are
bleeding.
Yeah, and there's something over there. Can you unlock that gate?
Yeah, now this is Lee Sing's thing. Repair.
Here we go.
Power. Whoa, we just got to level up.
Hell yeah.
Can you tame that cat?
You know, I can't tame any other animals because I already have one. Maybe if I level up my animals more, I can get more.
You need to level it up more.
Yeah, my whole point now is to play this game to tame the animals.
Honestly, the animals.
I know, it is pretty cool.
There are some cool skills that the team talked to me about, and I tried to replicate as best I could in my time with the game, but there's one build where you can have everybody sort of set up one character to do all the killing, and then like that character gets buffs when they kill a person, and they'll get extra AP. So if you can set it up right, set everybody up so they have almost no health, and then your one character will go in and finish everybody off and they get a boost of AP to like continue the onslaught, which is kind of nice.
Interesting.
Another build that I can't remember if I made it into the cover story or not, but just he talked about he was trying to like kill animals. Like you get boost if you kill animals, so you can get an XP boost. So he's like grinding away on like killing stray animals. But if somebody sees you do that, they might get upset and
why?
That might lead to a larger confrontation, unfortunately.
What's the big deal? That's my question.
It turns out people like cats.
Yeah. So before we start this fight, I'm going to go through everything we kind of got from the last one. Leveled up Lee Sing. So what, I can pick a new perk now?
Well, Dan, you had asked about the story a while ago.
I did.
And I want to continue to ignore that.
Wonderful.
Awesome.
The, I don't know, if you'd never played Wasteland, the original set in the 80s, it was like developed during the Cold War, so it kind of like played off those fears. And it's all about a nuclear war happens and then leads to this post-apocalyptic wasteland. It's a very fresh idea, I would say, these days. I don't think we've seen a lot of that.
Yeah.
Whoa, do you have a pile of pogs? How did those survive the apocalypse?
That's amazing. Pogs. Isn't that a thing that happened in the 90s? Like long after Wasteland would have...
They're already gone.
So they're the form of currency in the future.
Yeah.
So the first two games are set in Arizona, like 100 years after this war happened, and you're part of the Desert Ranger crew, which is trying to survive in the Wasteland, but also help your fellow man and kind of make a better world. And then this one, they're doing something a little bit different. They're moving to Colorado. So it's a winter. It's like a nuclear winter.
It's cold.
It's cold. It's a change of pace.
All right.
But
yeah,
you get contacted by this character named the Patriarch, who's the leader in Colorado. And he says, like, hey, come help me out. And I'll help you out. Scratch my back. I'll scratch yours. And he wants your help going out and collecting his children, because his children are kind of these young punk kids and they're trying to start a revolution, doing some bad stuff, and he wants your help putting them in line and kind of bringing them back to him. So that's what you're off to do. That's the setup for the story, and this is the early hours, so we haven't gone after any of his kids yet, but we've already met the Patriarch.
I see
Uh-oh.
That's fine. That was gonna happen.
So that's another thing you can upgrade, is like you can upgrade your sneaking skills, and you could get so good that you might be able to have one of your characters sneak through an entire encounter without getting detected. And then he might be able to wander into another area or a back door or something and open things up for you guys so that your entire party could just skip an encounter or multiple encounters.
That'd be cool. Yeah, my main goal is just to get Lee Sing up front because she has such weak movement but such good sniping. Yeah. Just want her to be in position to hit as many people as possible. Which would be cool. And these abilities, they charge over time, right? Or as you're getting kills? How does that work?
Yeah. Those abilities are kind of connected to your weapons. So if you change out your weapon, you'll get different ultimate abilities.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, they're fun. But then also your characters have a variety of their own abilities that they earn over time as you level up. So you can give boosts to other characters, or you can, you know, you'll get one skill that might allow you to attack characters multiple times with bladed weapons, for example. You also have gear that you can use. So you can throw like a smoke grenade that would blind enemies, and so they have less AP.
That sounds
cool.
There's
a lot of tools at your disposal, and we're kind of early on, so we don't have all those tools yet.
No, that's the strange thing about these kinds of games, is you just feel they're the hardest at the start. Mm-hmm. Like, it's definitely how I felt with XCOM Chimera Squad, is you definitely need all the tools. Yeah. I think I moved Lee Sing too far in front. She just got annihilated turn
so
one.
So she is surrounded. Did you have a pretty good shot on one of those guys over there? To your left?
I got the dog at 60%.
Yeah, well, even down there.
Oh, 83% on this guy. God, he's
the Beastmaster.
He's got to be the highest health guy out here, though. And you always go for the adds first, isn't that right, Dak?
Sometimes.
Oh no.
Really depends.
Oh no.
Oh no. What
have you done? Have you gotten a chance to use the vehicle yet? This is a big change to this game compared to the other Wasteland.
No, I don't know if that's in this build.
We'll try to show. Yeah, it is. We'll try to show that off in a bit.
So yeah, basically, instead of like just clicking around a world map, you have an actual Kodiak you drive around Colorado, and it's actually, you can use it in combat as well as both a giant weapon and a cover device.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, certain combat. It's not like every combat, but it is like
stuff in the overworld mostly, and certain battles. You can't take it in every battle, but
it is a wrecking ball. Like it does some good damage. It's really nice in combat encounters.
My goal here is to just dump.
So you'll meet people who have upgrades for your vehicle, and they can equip like new guns or treads or something to make it move around more. There's a lot of good options with that thing.
My goal here is to just wipe the Beastmaster. And I think I can do it if I focus everybody.
You can do it, dude.
Get the whole team involved.
That cat will act as cover for you.
Yeah. Half cover. Like fifth cover.
It's just chilling there. With all this gunfire going on.
Yeah, you can't control the cat or the beasts.
Ooh.
Hey, I did it. And Two-Face got an extra AP.
Good job, man.
For someone dying, so I might have an AP to back off now, but not to cover.
You get that half cover in front of you.
That's true.
Better than nothing.
That is better than nothing. Let's do that. There we go. You can wiggle. You can rotate.
Why'd you call him Two-Face?
I don't know. Because the portrait is so different from the character I made. It ended up being pretty fitting. This is the Two-Face is a character I generated by hitting random over and over again. So that's an example of the kind of cool look you can
pretty
go for.
Pretty cool.
Pretty
cool. No, yeah,
cool.
His character portrait is very different.
Okay,
the cool thing about that is you can import your own character portraits.
Oh, that is cool.
So if you have your own art and you want to include, if you even want to like include pictures of like your family or something, and just create your family in the game, you could do that.
Watch them die.
Exactly.
That's cool. Let's see. I guess I'm doing okay. I wish I could have finished off that ambusher that's right next to Lee Sing, but got rid of a major player.
We'll bleed out together.
Whoa, here they come. This isn't good.
They missed.
Haircuts.
Oh, I'm lucky.
Oh. So she's going rogue. I don't think she trusts your leadership at this point.
Who could blame her? You know?
Not me.
Lucky Mega Crit. Go off, William.
Will.
Will Nye. The Zion's guy. Who's the best to take out this? Sometimes it's like they're so weak. It's how do I get this person out?
Yeah.
With the,
like,
spending
55%
the least
shot, really?
Yeah, I mean, she's a sniper.
Right there. She might. Does she have a different gun you could, like, swap out for?
Oh, maybe I could have equipped one. Yeah, because you can have two weapon slots that you can switch between on the fly.
If you give her a pistol or something, she
I think
could.
She'd still want it. Yeah, let's see. I don't think she has enough explosives. Yeah, you can see the requirement for all this stuff. Requires four automatic weapons, two big guns, one automatic weapon. She can't handle any of this stuff.
Too hot to handle.
Too hot to handle. What are you gonna do?
She could, I don't know, heal herself maybe?
That seems like a good use of this turn. Earth doesn't even spend AP, does it? Maybe I back off then. Do I back off or go for the kill? I don't have the AP
to
go for the kill.
Get in there.
I'm going for the kill. You gotta get in there and mix it up, man.
I can't.
Even the guys who are further out, like, you don't have a good shot at them. Otherwise, you can just
She didn't have enough AP left over.
Oh.
As it turns out. Let's see. Who can Two-Face go and punch? Thrissa's is gonna spend all my AP getting there. Wow, that's a powerful Blood Beast. We hate to see that. I'll still have two left over, so bop them one and then get behind the cover.
Alright. You guys just got two-faced.
Did it to him two-face style. Gosh, nothing more frustrating in these games than being one stop short of where you want to be.
You can duck over to the right there, I guess. You still have a good shot at that porcupine.
And, you know, I'm doing so good on health. I may as well expose myself a little bit. I guess I should deal with this Blood Beast, huh? Not crazy about his proximity to my team.
I do like the fox and the cat are just chilling out there like, hey, cool. Nothing this exciting ever happens out here.
That's nature, man. I guess I'll just see if I can wait for them to attack me.
Sieve. All right, you really got to think this through, man. Got to strategize.
I know. Any tips appreciated?
Use your sniper.
Yep.
Always a good first bet. See if your sniper can clear anybody out. Man,
these shot percentages are trash, though. If they hit, they'd be good.
Real garbage. Yeah, I mean. You can back off and then you have a better shot.
I mean, I have to with her. She's not doing nothing. I'll back off by that Blood Beast.
Can anybody equip that grenade launcher you got?
Yeah, let's see. Who's got good explosives? Doc Nails.
Love Doc Nails.
Love Doc Nails.
Nails.
Frozen Ferret Launcher.
Yeah, the game has a really weird sense of humor.
It is very dry. Very goofy, but delivered in a very dry way.
Try goofy is a good way to put it. One of the things you can upgrade is a toaster repair, which has been a thing since way back in the day. But it lets you repair toasters and then you get stuff out of the toasters you repair. I just think that's a fun skill to have, toaster repair.
Yeah. It's a full skill. It's got perks along the tree and everything. Oh, new sniper.
Ooh.
I just
looted. So you got a vehicle upgrade there? That's nice.
Yeah. Let's see.
I don't know. Can you just focus on that beast?
I would if I was had ammo. Oh, and I clicked on a corpse and looted it instead. And I can't reload. What's going on with that?
Are you out of ammo completely?
Oh, right. Yeah, that is a limited resource.
Yeah.
God.
Yeah, that's the tough thing about this game is like ammo is so limited that you really want to equip different guns to everybody. And you probably want to have a couple of melee characters going just so they're not all using ammo.
Yeah, I'm out of ammo for so much. Okay, this I can load. But I'm out of AP, so I did my part. I tried.
Back to here.
Good nice turn, everyone. Thank you.
Oh, ooh, come on.
Clutch miss.
Lucia.
Got some action points back. I'm lucky. Oh, wow.
There we go.
That's what I needed. And then.
Yeah, you just need somebody to finish them off.
Wow, easy as that.
Easy as pie. Do you guys know where that expression comes from?
Oh, I don't know.
Tell us the story, Reeves.
From Wasteland, the original.
Wow.
That is a very good story.
Yeah.
I'm gonna deploy this ferret launcher.
Yeah, here you go. Blow some stuff up, dude.
Is it gonna hurt me if I do this? Probably, right?
I don't know if I've used the ferret launcher yet, but...
Well, I don't have AP anyway, because I reloaded.
Yeah, it's a trick.
Another good turn from Doc Nails.
You want to manage, it's all about managing your resources, like make sure you have ammo and guns equipped that you can use.
Yeah.
And try not to run too far into battle and overextending yourself. There you go.
Comboed on.
There's a cool, like if you're using just melee, not even weapons, but just using your fists. There's some cool upgrades near the end of that chain where early on it's pretty weak, but the more you upgrade just your melee abilities, you can combo like an insane person and just hit somebody like 20 times. And the more you hit him, it exponentially does more damage. So it'll start off pretty weak, but by the fifth time you're doing like half their health.
So
that's an option. Have somebody who's just an insane boxer or something.
Yeah, it's fun preparing one turn and then being able to get like an 8-hit combo off with the for brawlers.
Sure. But you're doing pretty good. Like I was a little worried early on, but I think we're gonna pull through on this one.
Thank God for turn-based. I have 6 more turns than this guy.
That's a lot of turns.
Let's hope it's enough. God, I just can't quite hit anybody. That's fine, we'll all hang out.
You can overwatch him? Oh, yeah. He's a melee dude.
You can still set up an ambush.
Yeah.
Reaction attack. Opportunity attack.
Didn't expect this, did ya?
All of these people bleeding. Let's get some heals going. Oh! He's executed an ambush.
Oh.
So
the student has become the master.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice.
Oh, I needed that. F- finally he can shoot this rocket launcher and it would clearly just kill us all.
Do it to it.
I'm gonna try every other option first.
Good. There you go. That's Wasteland 3 combat. The cool thing is you can loot everything in a vicinity all at once, so you don't have to like go to each individual pocket to loot.
Somebody. Yeah.
Although it looks like there's maybe one that got missed out there. But
what's in that pit?
By me, no.
I don't know what the range is on it, so sometimes it, if there's a guy who's really far out.
Right. Yeah, I wish it was just like the whole scene. That'd be cool. But yeah, good quality of life stuff like that. Like, I think there's no limit on the inventory space.
Yeah, that is nice.
God, I appreciate that.
Because, yeah, nothing's more annoying than a weight limit.
Yeah.
You got six people here. They can carry whatever they want.
Exactly.
Some good customization skills, too. And you can change, like, if you don't like the cosmetic, you can, like, turn the cosmetic part off, which is nice, too.
Yeah, and modding, it'll go, it'll show you who's doing the modding, like who has your best.
Yeah, who's your modder.
Modding, yeah. It's cool to have somebody dedicated to that. Almost like a support role in kind of a cool RPG way.
So yeah, it really has a team feel to it, which is nice. So you're building up your team, your squad, and making the ultimate squad.
So we just jumped ahead a little bit. We found the people we were looking for. Lucia's family, I assume.
Well, hopefully they know where Lucia's family is.
To offer our unconditional surrender. As proof of our goodwill, I want to tell you that the culprits got into town with help from Farron Brigo's organization, and...
Does it bother you, sir, that we're exploding blood out of us every few seconds?
Farron Brigo.
How could you uh-huh.
That's gotta be the slickest take where on a name I've ever seen.
Weird nice. Coincidence that one of the... The founders of Interplay was Brian Fargo, right?
Very strange.
They're in the grave you passed on the way here. They didn't suffer, Lucia. I promise. Baby, look. I didn't mean it to go this way. I tried to stop them. I really did. I begged.
Stop talking right now.
So, yeah. He's basically the reason her family is dead. So,
and that's bad.
I don't know what. Yeah, I mean, it depends on your view of death, I guess. But yeah, most people would consider that a bad thing. That he did a wrong. So I don't know how you guys want to deal with that. Or do you guys?
I need more details.
It was Melius Dorsey.
I need more details before I can come to a conclusion here.
Your family, mm-hmm. especially. That's why I got you out of your house before the raid. I didn't want anything to happen to you.
You didn't want anything to happen to me? So you let savages abduct and murder my family. You knew what they meant to me. You knew what their loss would do to me.
But you're still alive, Lucia. Don't you see? You're still alive, and that's what matters most to me.
So this guy, he basically thinks he's doing a good thing, like, overall for the community, but he got people killed. So you can like kill him right here, which could have some consequences. You could try to have a fair trial. You could
a fair him. Trial.
I'm all about a fair trial.
Gang helped them get into town. I don't.
But no matter what you choose, like.
And I overheard Neely.
Different people in the world will react to that.
Yeah, this seems really, really positive. This is like basically a Disney story, right, Reeves? That's what we got going on here.
I think right.
Yeah.
Happy ending awaits.
Pocahontas,
princesses, and
out in the plains.
Yeah.
Way
yeah.
worse than the Dorsey.
There are factions, right?
Happy ending.
Different factions that factions,
yeah.
you can align with.
Mm-hmm.
The Gippers.
Different factions. Some people will end up hating you, depending on who you choose. Some people might hunt you down for revenge.
Right, so in one playthrough, it's impossible to ally with every faction, right? Because, like, doing something nice to one faction will make you really... will make you hated with the other ones, yeah? With certain other ones.
Right.
That the 100 families are in charge, but it's really just his family. Just him. I know you must think I'm a fuzzy-headed idealist, but... This society is sick.
There was one dialogue sequence earlier in the game where it was a close-up on the person's face. Does that happen much more?
Those do occur. Those are generally saved for, like, when I talked to the team and I was out there, special scenes with big characters, essentially.
Right.
But they will have those sort of cinematic encounters where you can, like, alter their actions and stuff by your responses and sometimes get them to do very weird things.
Yeah, I'm hoping they do more of it in the finished game. From what I saw, it was pretty limited, and really it's just a close-up shot of the person talking, so it's not... They call it a cinematic camera, but really it's just a close-up of the guy. So I'm hoping... It's not like Mass Effect, which is what I think of when I think of cinematic camera work, right?
I know you guys probably saw, like, the opener one, I guess, but, like, I got to see some of the ones from later where you deal with some of the Patriarch's kids up close and personal, and they get really weird.
Yeah, they sound like a bunch of psychos.
You're basically choosing, of the many endings you can get, and that's why that we're talking about, like, dialogue here, there's so many different ways you can take the game. Of the many directions you can take things, like, you know, you can side with one of the kids against the Patriarch, you can side with the Patriarch. There's three different kids, so that's three different plot lines right there, you know?
Yeah. Do you remember which kid you encountered?
I saw all of them.
Oh, really?
Okay. At various points, yes.
Yeah, I remember, I did the victory one. Vic Buchanan is the oldest son, who's, like, the psychopath, and he can actually, like, join your party, which is an interesting choice, so if you bring him along, he'll just join your group for the rest of the game. But he's also a psychopath, so...
He is completely nuts. I got to see his sequence, his dialogue sequence, and I got to... I don't know. You've seen it, so I don't want to ruin it, and I won't, but there's some really weird stuff going on with that dude.
But imagine having the Joker in your game and how people would react if, like, you were hanging out with the Joker.
Like in GTA 5.
That's what it'd be kind of... Yeah, exactly.
Cool. So should we encourage a fair trial here?
Fair trial. We're all about fair trials.
Yeah, come on, Lucia. We're not barbarians.
Not after what he did to my
family. Yeah, I didn't mean to get off on a tangent there, but I felt it was, you know, there are big story decisions to be made, as well as small ones that only probably impact this guy and his relationship to you.
Right.
Ooh. So you could lose
some
out with Lucia here if you just don't let her kill him, but also then a guy.
What happens if you let him go? Do they still shoot? Like, you've got autonomy here, so when you say let him go, they're really going to let him go, right?
And
this isn't like The Witcher, where it's like, hey, I'm going to save you, and then they hang him.
Yeah, the way they seem to dispense justice is by killing him anyway.
Right.
To bring him back to town, so I guess we'll put him under arrest. Blood won't be on my hands.
What did this guy do? Right here,
in the palm of my hand. He got Lucia's family killed.
There was this massacre that happened, and that's how Lucia's family died, and he was basically one of the insiders that let this other group... gave him information that helped lead to the massacre, let's say.
Oh, wow. Yeah, we should have killed him.
Yeah. Oh, man. What did
it's
we
not
do?
Too late.
What a scumbag. He's a traitor.
I'm just more interested to see what happens when we arrest him, because I'm pretty sure what will happen when we shoot him, you know?
All right. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm actually not happy we saved this jerk.
Yeah.
You're all about street justice, huh?
I mean, we know he deserved it, right?
Well, you're welcome to kill him in your playthrough, and that's the magic of it.
I'm going to, and it won't be kind either.
We're creating multiple timelines. One where he lives, one where he dies. Let's hand the prisoners over ourselves.
Happy to hear that, Team November, as am I. Good job getting those some bitches. Over and out.
Yoink. There we go. That's the end of the demo I have, I guess.
Oh, well done on the demo. We did
Thank
it.
Thank you. I mastered it. Cool. Well, Wasteland 3, what more is there to say? We've got that cover story. It's the cover story on our latest issue of the magazine, which is out right now in digital and coming to your mailbox very soon. Thanks for joining me, guys.
Yeah, thanks for showing it off, Leo. It was a great time.
Yeah, when's
it
coming out?
Here.
We know when it's coming out?
Game's coming out this August.
Awesome.
I hope. Since I said it.
God willing.
Yeah, I mean, it's been delayed, but they're doing a lot of good work to it. It's fully voiced. Microsoft owns InXile, so they've been able to put some money behind it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, August 28th is when it's coming out, so stay tuned.
Great. Thanks, guys. Bye. Gaming can be hard. Watching people play games shouldn't be. New Gameplay Today is your path to getting fun, informational previews of upcoming games and the releases of the day. It's New Gameplay Today, a marginally new way to spend your time.